Welcome, my dear friends. Myself, Professor Dr. Deshpande, would like to welcome you in this Ayurvedic Generic Medicines Contents and Indications Part 2. I am mentioning all these audio sessions in alphabetical sequence. In the Part 1 session, I have completed the discussion about tablet Agni Tundi and tablet Ashwakanchuki. And now in this audio session, I would like to discuss with you regarding Ayurvedic tablets Anandbhairav and tablet Arogyavardhini. First, Anandbhairav. Second, Arogyavardhini. Anandbhairav has two different formulations, like Anandbhairav Kas and Anandbhairav Atisar. But right now, I would like to discuss Anandbhairav Kas. Contents and indications, of course, are different. So whenever you go to the Ayurvedic medical shop and you demand for Anandbhairav, then on the label you will have to confirm whether this Anandbhairav Kas or whether this is Anandbhairav Atisar. So you have to be very careful. Now I will discuss Anandbhairav Kas. Kas means cough, C-O-U-G-H. Cough in the modern medicine, in Ayurveda, it is called as a kas. Kasanat kas uchate. A specific sound is created, and that's why the process is called as a kas in Sanskrit. Now, what are the contents of Anandbhairav? Basically, it contains the bachanag, and of course, antidote of bachanag is always there whenever there is a bachanag, aconitum ferox. Vachanag, it is used in a purified form, remember, nothing to be worried about. But antidote is a tankana, that is borax. Vatsanab or the Vachanag is a main ingredient, and there is a tankan or the borax is an antidote to avoid the side effects of the Vachanag. Another important ingredient in Anandbhairav Kas is Hingul. Hingul, this particular medicine is very, very nice acting on the respiratory tract. And there is also the maricha or the mire, that is black pepper, and pippali, that is piper longum. So only three or four important ingredients are there: bachanag or vatsanab, aconitum ferox, antidote is tankan. The best dravya hingul for respiratory tract, and supportive drugs are the maricha and the pippali, and bhavana dravya, in which it is triturated, that is adrak juice. It is a wheat ginger juice. Wheat ginger juice, adrak swaras. All the ingredients are triturated in adrak swaras, and Anandbhairav Kas tablet is prepared. This is the best medicine for cough problem. This is the best medicine. Anandbhairav Kas, this is the best medicine for cough problem internally. Because there is a maricha and pippali, which is the best drug, like remove the stickiness of the cough. They are ushna, tikshna in properties, hot and penetrating in properties. They are opposite properties of kapha, like guru, sheet, snigdha, manda. These are the properties of kapha dosha. That means heavy in nature, sticky in nature. And maricha and pippali, they remove the stickiness of the kapha dosha. It is very mucolytic in action, and they try to take the kapha outside your body. That is called as expectorant. So maricha and pippali, they take care of this kapha. Hingul basically tries to reduce the inflammation of the kapha secreting the glands, and it tries to reduce that kapha secretion. It tries to take the precaution of infections. Hingul and Bachanag, these two drugs are antiseptic also in nature, antibiotic type the work they do, and they try to remove the infection from this respiratory tract. So Hingul and Bachanag are very good to take care of infections and to control the kapha secretions. So, Anandbhairav Kas can be used for cold, cough, URTI, upper respiratory tract infection, or LRTI, lower respiratory tract infection. For the absorption, for reduction of the kapha secretions, Hingul is benefited by the addition of Tankana, borax. This also reduces the secretions. Kapha Shoshan function, that is called as a Kapha Shoshan, absorption of excessive secretions. Ardrakasvaras or ginger juice also helps to reduce the kapha in chest and in pharynx and in nose and in the sinuses. Now, Bachanag, Aconitum ferox, is best diaphoretic. That means it improves in the sweat formation, sweating. And as you know very well, sweating can help to reduce the fever. Sweating can help to reduce fever. So whenever there is a cough with fever, this Anandbhairav Kas can be prescribed. Cough with fever is always there in URTI or LRTI. So actually this cough problem usually starts whenever the patient indulge or take the cold substances in excess, or he go into the crowded places and he get the infection from the another person by droplet infection. First beginning symptom is only irritation to the throat, that is called as a pharyngitis, then laryngitis. Before that also there is a rhinitis. And if the rhinitis means the nasal secretions are increased. If it is what you can say the accumulated in the sinuses, it is called as a sinusitis. So all these are kapha problems. Then gradually, to begin with, when there is a pharyngitis, laryngitis, there may be dry cough. But afterwards, after 2, 3, 4 days, expectoration starts. Expectoration may be white, yellow or green. Cough with expectoration. The doctor should ask, what is the color of expectoration? When it is white, nothing to be worried about. Many times it is without any infection. But whenever there is a yellow or green sputum, it is 99% infective focus is there. And then here Bachanag will be helpful to reduce that infection. When the infection goes down, the person will land into the bronchitis. Then there may be bronchiolitis. Then there may be pneumonia. By chance, the person may suffer from pleurisy. This is all kapha problems. Sometimes tuberculosis. But Anandbhairav Kas, better way you give for the rhinitis, pharyngitis with expectoration, sinusitis, bronchitis, and as far as possible pneumonia. But for TB and pleurisy, another important drugs also should be added. Anandbhairav Kas is for URTI, LRTI with fever, with cough. That Bachanag also take care of body ache associated with the fever. So, this is the best drug for the URTI, LRTI, Anandbhairav Kas for cough problems. Tablet is of 125 milligram, 2 tablets, 3 times in a day. 2 TDS. If the infection is serious, then 2 QID also can be given, 4 times in a day. This tablet better way should be taken with making a paste, crushing the tablet and making a paste in ginger juice and honey if it is possible. Ginger juice and honey is the anupana or the vehicle or the carrier for this tablet Anandbhairav Kas. Anandbhairav Kas with ginger juice and honey. But if it is not possible, if you are going to the office on the 3rd, 4th day, then you can take with warm water. Remember, kapha should be treated with Anandbhairav Kas in addition to the Pathyapathya, that is the do's and don'ts. Always drink warm water. Don't expose yourself to the cold drink, cold beverages, cold food, freezed atom and AC. These are the basic fundamental requisites, as Ayurveda says, to take care of kapha problems. Kapha word is Ayurved, kapha word is modern. Ayurvedic kapha bioenergy dosha, K-A-P-H-A. Modern kapha, C-O-U-G-H, kapha. Anandbhairav Kas, that we have already discussed. In this audio session 2, Ayurvedic generic medicines, part 2, I will talk about Arogyavardhini. This is very, very, very important tablet in Ayurveda. Nearly all Vaidyas use this tablet enormously, in a large amount. Such important is this tablet, Arogyavardhini. The name itself suggests, the name of tablet Arogyavardhini itself gives you the idea. What is the effect of this magic tablet? Arogya means health, and Vardhini to promote. Arogyavardhini tablet promotes your health. Arogyavardhini tablet promotes your health. Hence the name Arogya, health, Vardhini. This Arogyavardhini tablet is used independently in many diseases, as well as in combination with various formulations of another medicines. Why this tablet is important? Let us see. The main ingredient of Arogyavardhini, the main ingredient is Kutaki. Kutaki is the name of herb. Picror Haiza Kuro. Kutaki, Kutki, Katuka. This is the herb. Very, very bitter in taste. But this is the best medicine for Pitta Virechana. Pitta Rechana, I can say. To give the proper secretion of bile, proper secretion of digestive juices, proper secretions from liver, all they are stimulated with the herb Kutaki, Picror Haiza Kuro, which is the main ingredient, nearly 50% in Arogyavardhini tablet. And it is supplemented with para and gandhaka, mercury and sulfur. So it becomes a rasa aushadhi. And as I am repeatedly telling, whenever there is a paragandhak, main ingredients, they work fast. Kutki will act fastly, number one. In a very, very, very small dose. Number three, quick in action, longer shelf life. This can be preserved for 2-3 years. But if you keep only Kutki powder in your dispensary, it will be destroyed within 6 months period. So long shelf life, it can be preserved longer. Effect is very fast, very small dose. If you ask the patient to take this Kutki powder, 2 spoon, 3 spoon, 4 gram, 5 gram, he will not take. It is very, very bitter in taste. Patient will not come to you again. But for the same effect, for the same purpose, if you advise him, take Arogyavardhini tablet, 250 milligram, two tablets, three times in a day with water, he will be happy. The effect will be same, but in a smaller dose. So, the patient's response, patient's compliance is very fantastic with Arogyavardhini tablet. Arogyavardhini, because of Kutki, proper Pittrechan, this is the main drug to act on liver. I will say this is the number one liver medicine in Ayurveda, not only liver tonic. Of course, Arogyavardhini is the best liver tonic, but Arogyavardhini is best liver medicine. And that's why here is the important, what you can say, the magic. Liver is the main industry in our body. Liver is the main industry in our body. Lot of metabolic processes are taking place in the liver. It may be protein metabolism, it may be carbohydrate metabolism, it may be fat metabolism. All are taking place in the liver. Then blood is detoxified, blood is purified in the liver. All the toxins from the body, they are eliminated through the bile secretion. So it is a purificatory also industry in our body. So one is a nutritive industry, food industry, to prepare a good nutrients for your body, and another is a cleansing garbage system is also liver. So it is a multi-dimensional, multifunctional organ, that is the liver. And that's why the medicine acting on the liver is acting on the whole body. Remember my words. So Arogyavardhini can be prescribed from cold to the cancer. Arogyavardhini can be prescribed as a main medicine or adjuvant medicine from cold, that is normal watering from the nose, up to the cancer. I am giving you the range of the diseases. From mild disease to the serious disease, you must use the Arogyavardhini in your practice. Kutaki, Picrorhiza Kuro, Paragandhak. In addition to that, there are another some important ingredients, that is a Shilajatu. Shilajatu, black bitumen, is the best rasayan according to Ayurveda. It is the best rasayan for your body. Then there is a three types of basma: Loha basma, Abhrak basma, and Tamra basma. In Arogyavardhini, Loha, Abhrak, and Tamra basma are there. Iron, copper, mica, these all basmas are there. Then there is a Kuggulu. Then there is a Chitrakmul, which are stimulating to your digestive fire. And also there is a mild laxative, that is Trifala. So this is a very good combination of the multiple which help to recover our body from many diseases or to cure many diseases. Okay, we will start one by one indication. As I have already mentioned, this is the best medicine for any liver problem. Let us start with the infective hepatitis problem. Infective hepatitis is an inflammation of liver due to the virus A, virus B, virus C, virus D, virus E, etc., etc. But the commonest jaundice seen in the society is because of the virus A from the impure water or the food. Impure water and food gives you the jaundice, kavi, kamala, and that gives you the icterus, yellow tinge to the nails and eyes. The main complaint, anorexia. The patient don't want to see even the food, he starts nausea and vomiting. Then there will be tender hepatomegaly, and in the urine you will get the bile salts and bile pigments. Remember, and serum bilirubin, blood bilirubin level will be increased. So all this is an infective hepatitis, jaundice. For the jaundice, I personally have made the research with well-known physician Dr. S. Y. Wagh in Pune many years back. We have in the Nano Hospital, Karve Road, Pune, we have made two groups of 20 patients each. Because for the infective hepatitis, jaundice, there is no specific treatment in modern medicine. Dr. S. Y. Wagh is basically BMS, but then he had completed LCPS, MBBS, and he is a modern medicine MD doctor. MD. Remember, he said that there are limitations for some diseases, and then we decided to make a control group. One group is treated with normal traditional allopathic management, and another group was given tablet Arogyavardhini, 3 tablets, 3 times in a day, with Kumari Asava number 1, aloe vera. Kumari is aloe vera, Korfad. Kumari Asava number 1, 3 spoon with 3 spoon of water and 3 spoon medicine diluted, 3 times in a day. And what we have observed, that research was very successful because the treated group had a better recovery and fast recovery. How? The normal treated with the modern management, that group started the appetite after 2 weeks duration. Their bilirubin levels comes down after 2 weeks. But the group treated with Arogyavardhini and Kumaryasa, they regain their appetite within a period of only 1 week. Their bilirubin level goes down within a period of only 1 week. So when you use the Arogyavardhini and Kumaryasa, your jaundice patient will definitely recover very fastly. So my kind request, use this my research in your practice. When the infective hepatitis Kamala is with virus A, I am talking about virus A, remember, not about virus B. Virus B is called as a serum jaundice. That is from the infected needles, infected blood, infected mother. It's very similar to the HIV, hepatitis B. That is another thing. There is a bhumyam laki. In Ayurveda, you can use bhumyam laki for infective hepatitis B. I am talking about Arogyavardhini in infective hepatitis A is a very good solution. Very good solution. Use Arogyavardhini and Kumaryasa in Kamala, infective hepatitis. Then, of course, I am not saying you should not use in hepatitis B. Hepatitis B, hepatitis C, hepatitis D, even hepatic amoeboma, even hepatic cancer, even hepatic cirrhosis, you must use the Arogyavardhini. But there you will have to use many other medicines also. But Arogyavardhini, yes, you can use it in any liver problem. But is it only for liver? No. Arogyavardhini can also be used in many other conditions. Let us see one by one. It can be used for different types of edema in the body. Edema. Especially I am talking about whole body edema. It is called as anasarca. A-N-A-S-A. Anasarca. There are three main causes for this edema. Number one, liver damage, cirrhosis. You get the edema on the legs. Renal edema. Renal, because of the kidney damage. Then you get the periorbital swelling early in the morning. Then there may be cardiac edema due to the CCF, congestive cardiac failure. That also you get the pedal edema in the evening. So whatever the type of edema, I will recommend you must use the Arogyavardhini tablet, minimum 2 tablets 3 times in a day with Punarnavasava. With Punarnavasava, that is also the diuretic. Because Arogyavardhini will definitely stimulate to your damaged cells, and also it will take care of removing the other pathological factors. Next, as I have mentioned, that liver is concerned with the two elements of our body. That is, the one is a pitta dosha, liver connected with pitta, liver connected with the rakta dhatu. Liver yakruta connected with pitta, liver yakrut connected with rakta dhatu. Don't forget this relation. And we are saying, whenever there is a pitta and rakta, the best treatment is to take the vitiated dosha and dhatu through the laxative, through the virechan, take them out, and kutki will help you. And that's why in all skin diseases, because of the impure blood, for example, scabies, for example, eczema, for example, tinea cruris, fungal infections, in staphylococcal infections, streptococcal infections, impetigo, many skin diseases, psoriasis, leucoderma, I will say any skin disease. Whatever the medicines you use it. But in addition to that, also give Arogyavardhini tablet to these patients of skin diseases. Of course, why I am recommending, there is another factor in the ingredient. Arogyavardhini, Paragandhak, Lohabhasma, Abhrakbhasma, Tamrabhasma, Katuka, they are given the bhavana, samskar, trituration with kadunimba juice, Azha diracta indica, nimba, kadunimba juice. Kadunimba juice is a bhavana dravya for Arogyavardhini. Kadunimba juice. Don't forget, kadunimba juice. And as you know, kadunimba is a bitter in taste, and any bitter thing is very good for pitta dosha. Kadunimba is excellent anti-infective, best antibiotic, best antiseptic. Nimba, don't forget, nimba antiseptic. And that's why in any skin disease, even there is infection, it will be taken care by Arogyavardhini tablets, and it will purify the blood. Then another indication, Arogyavardhini contains, in addition to the Paragandhak, Loha, Abhrak and Tamra Bhasma. Loha, Abhrak and Tamra, iron and copper, very very essential for hemoglobin formation, RBC formation, erythropoiesis. So whenever the patient comes for anemia, when hemoglobin is low, don't give only tapyadi loha, don't give only mandura vatak, don't give only kasisa bhasma. In anemia, don't give only lohaso. You must add tablet Arogyavardhini for any anemic patient. Especially, I will talk about iron deficiency anemia. Of course, you can use it in another anemic types like aplastic anemia, like megaloblastic anemia. Yes, we can use it, no problem. But basic indication is iron deficiency anemia, especially when hemoglobin is frequently dropped down, then Arogyavardhini will treat the basic pathology in the liver. Next indication for Arogyavardhini. I am saying Arogyavardhini for liver, liver, pitta and rakta. Always remember these connections. Arogyavardhini, pitta. Pitta is for inflammation. Pitta causes inflammatory processes in the body. Pitta dosh, according to Ayurveda, when it is disturbed, provocated, vitiated, it causes pak. Pak means inflammation. In the modern pathology, whenever there is a ITIS, this is the suffix letters, ITIS suffix letters, it indicates inflammation. I will give you example. Tonsillitis, inflammation of tonsil. Pharyngitis, inflammation of pharynx. Laryngitis, inflammation of larynx. So, my dear friends, whenever you find that there is inflammatory processes in the body, especially I am talking about tonsillitis, because tonsils, they are always, the parents are also afraid when the child gets the tonsillitis, the doctors are always recommending them the operation. So, in that case, I will recommend better way, you first try the Arogyavardhini, Trifala Guggul and Kanchanar Guggul. Mind my formula. Arogyavardhini 2 tablets, Kanchanar Guggul 2 tablets, Trifala Guggul 2 tablets, 3 times in a day. You must try before going for any operation. That can also take care of your controlling the inflammation of tonsils. Then, Arogyavardhini is also used when there is a constipation, especially chronic constipation, because the main pathology is proper digestive juices are not secreted, the kutki will help in that particular condition. Next indication of Arogyavardhini is a chronic fever. As you know, PUO, pyrexia of unknown origin, many times all the investigations, they come normal and the patient is suffering from the mild fever and it is not controlled by any higher antibiotics and so. In these conditions, Arogyavardhini also can try to recorrect your basic pathology in the body by correcting the all metabolic processes, and it can be very well useful as an adjuvant drug in your routine drugs for Jirana Jvara. Jirnajwara, I will recommend, don't forget two drugs. One is a guduchi, that is sanshamani guti, or guduchi ghanavati. But guduchi ghanavati should be given in higher doses. And also, I will recommend shatavari ghrita. Shatavari ghrita, ghrita is recommended when the fever is of more than 3 weeks duration or more than 15 days duration, because body is lost with lot of main ingredients or main elements or main tissues part from our body, and body is having the degenerative changes in very, very chronic fever. So three drugs I will recommend: Arogyavardhini, then Guduchi Ghanavati, and also the Shatavari Ghrita. Next indication for Arogyavardhini is a typical another feature is hypertension. The people will be get shocked. What is the relation of liver and hypertension? But again, I am telling you, in Ayurveda, Ayurveda says that hypertension is caused maybe because of the pitta vrita vata. Vata is there, but that is a pitta vrita vata. So there is a pitta dosha affecting the, obstructing the vata dosha. And that's why that pitta is taken care by kutaki of Arogyavardhini. And to control blood pressure, especially I am talking about long-term treatment, you have to give the Arogyavardhini for nearly 6 months, 3 months, then give a gap of 8 days, again start the Arogyavardhini, 2 tablets early in the morning on empty stomach, and after that half an hour you can take the breakfast. So Arogyavardhini continuously, if the patient is taking, then we are sure that pitta rechan will take place, and as the blood pressure is related with the blood or the rakta dhatu, which is a raktava srotas problem, and raktava srotas channel is mainly connected as a mulasthan with the liver, and that's why this all circuit will complete, and Arogyavardhini will be helpful to control the blood pressure in a long run. Remember, it is not emergency management. There are a lot of drugs that you usually prescribe for the hypertension. There are different types of the hypertension. One is called as a simple hypertension, primary hypertension, another is a secondary hypertension. I am not talking about secondary hypertension, I am talking about primary hypertension or essential hypertension, which is idiopathic in nature. Stress is the main factor for that thing, and a patient is always taking say beta blockers or calcium channel blockers or ACE inhibitors. In Ayurveda, they are recommended Sarpaganda or Duralabha, or the Dhamasa is the best medicine, like Duralabhadi Kadha we always prescribe. So Duralabhadi Kadha can be given with this particular Arogyavardhini, or even the Rasagandha tablet, which contains the Sarpaganda, Jatamasi, etc., etc. Anyway, Arogyavardhini also given, prescribed for chronic hypertension as a maintenance to control or to prevent the up and downs in the blood pressure. Then Kavir, as I have already discussed about jaundice, Arogyavardhini is the number one. Then for the patients of ascites, remember, Udara ascites is a complication with liver cirrhosis. So for the ascites patients, for edema patients, for chronic fever, for skin problems, for hypertension, Arogyavardhini, or many, there are lot of indications for Arogyavardhini. In a simple sentence I have mentioned, it can be used as a main drug or as your adjuvant drug from cold to cancer type of the range of the diseases. So Arogyavardhini is prepared from katuka, picrohiza kuro, supplemented with paragandhak, loha abrak and tamrabhasma, trifala, shilajatu and gugulu, and bhavana dravya is kadu nimb juice. This is a dose is taken as a 2 tablets 3 times in a day. Tablet may be of 125 milligram or 250 milligram. So my dear friends, in this particular audio session, audio video session of Ayurvedic Generic Medicines Part 2, I have discussed tablet Anandbhairav Kas and tablet Arogyavardhini. I hope this information will be helpful for in your medical practice or to understand Ayurveda in a better concept. So thank you very much for hearing, and I wish you all the best. Please ask your friends and yourself to subscribe my YouTube channel to get this very scientific information but very simple and interesting language. Thank you very much.